we start today by asking, how can you make ends meet in a time of rising prices? What's the best way to make your money stretch? And that's exactly what Mrs. Sheila Roberts from Bolton wants to know. Sheila, after paying your rent and your electricity bills and your rates and all those extras, how much money do you have left for food?
Approximately £12.
£12 a week,
yes.
Right? And how much of that do you spend on fresh meat?
An average 1.83p.
£1.83. Right. Average. And on fresh veg?
Last week it was £1.20.
And do you drink a lot of milk in your family?
Yes, we do. We use a lot of milk and it works out to £1.63 a week for milk.
£1.63 a week. Mm-hmm. Now, at this point, I'd like to introduce Georgie Rodgers. She's a home economist who has ideas for all of us on how to make our pounds stretch further. Georgie, I know you've been looking at details of Sheila's weekly budget and meal plans, and before you give us your ideas, let me ask Sheila to give us a typical day's meals, a breakdown, say, of Thursday.
Well, for breakfast, for my husband, the three school children and the baby, they had cornflakes, milk and sugar, and a pot of tea. I had coffee and toast. For lunch, I bought a meat and potato pie off the bread man. And we had it between us with two rounds of bread and butter. For tea, when the children come home, they like to raid the bread bin and help themselves to what they call their jam double-decker. It consists of three rounds of bread and butter with jam in between. Mm. And they sort of munch that in front of the television. And main meal, we had minced beef pie, chips and peas, and out of the leftovers of the pastry, I made a jam window pie. Mm-hmm. Before they went to bed for supper, they had hot chocolate and biscuits. The children had that. And my husband and I had coffee and some biscuits.
Right, that's your rundown for Thursday.
For Thursday.
Georgie, what general comments first?
Well, I would like to make some suggestions for more variety in the menu and paying particular attention to dishes with slightly higher food value than the bread, the jam, the biscuits and so on. Some variation that would apply to the menus for the whole week. I think mm-hmm. we could take Thursday as a typical day. If menu planning for the main meal was done for the whole week and then the shopping list prepared from that, we could cook perhaps three times a week and look towards the Monday lunch for Sheila and the baby from the previous evening's supper dish.
Or from the Sunday joint,
perhaps. Or from yes. the Sunday joint, yes. Yeah. For the breakfast, we've got the husband and all the children going off to school with cornflakes, no cooked breakfast. Now, this cold weather, I think it would be a good idea to introduce some porridge.
Children don't like porridge.
Well,
anything else, if they don't like porridge?
Well, they're not getting anything hot then until their school lunch, mm. which is not a very good thing in the cold weather.
Perhaps you could persuade them, Sheila. Mm.
Well, if they don't like it with hot milk, try it with a little golden
yes.
syrup or a little honey on it. Perhaps they've not had it that way. Now for your lunch, you and the baby don't seem to fare very well. And I'm worried here, Sheila, because you're the important member of the family. If you're not going to eat well, you've only had coffee and toast for breakfast, if you're not going to eat well, you're not going to keep well. And so I'd like to see that these lunches for you and the baby were a little more interesting and a little more substantial, and introduce a little fruit into the menu. Mm. Mm. Yes. The baby isn't getting any fruit at all from the schedule as I've seen.
Yes, I'd like to just, as we've mentioned that, why is there so little fruit? Do they really not like it?
Well, you see, everything in supermarkets is pre-packed. In fours, usually apples. Oranges, usually in fours. And, quite frankly, I prefer to spend more on fresh meat than on fruit.
But what about buying at the, you know, vegetable shop, the greengrocer, instead
well,
of pre-packed?
They're just as expensive, really, and we haven't had one locally. Simple as that. We just haven't got a greengrocer's locally.
Okay.
It's all pre-packed.
Right, I want to take you back to this lunch now, because you were mentioning meal planning, Georgie.
Yes.
What would you suggest Sheila could have on Thursday, which is a leftover from what she cooked
well,
on Wednesday?
Well, if we had a bacon joint on Wednesday evening, This would make a very good supper for the whole family. The liquor could be used for a good soup for Shelia and the baby on Thursday. Leftovers from the bacon joint could be used for a roly-poly or a risotto or stuffed pancakes or a very interesting make-up dish. And this...
Could I just come in there a minute? If you're, do a make-up dish,
yes.
You know, doctor up the leftovers, if you like. Well, wouldn't it be just as expensive making the mixtures with pancake mixture, taking the eggs and the milk and everything else, as buying a 9p meat and potato pie?
No, but this is for your evening meal.
Oh, for the evening
this
meal.
This is for
I
the
thought
evening
we were talking
meal.
About lunch, I'm sorry.
No, your lunch is, I was suggesting, a soup made from the liquor and fruit.
Mm. Mm. The roly-poly was going to be what
the
we
main
came
meal
from
for
the
evening, yes. in place of this minced beef pie, chips and peas. Mm.
But that is the point. I mean, these suggestions you're making, obviously some of them are going to sound expensive to Shelia, but aren't they in lieu...
They're in lieu of something else. They're in lieu of the ingredients that you're buying for the minced beef pie.
Mm-hmm. Yes, but the minced beef, it is a fairly cheap dish. I find, you know, to make a mince pie, I spend 22 pence on the mince and one onion at 4p. And a little bit of Bisto gravy,
yes.
You know, doctors it up a little bit and makes a substantial pie.
And you're making enough pastry there to have it left over,
yes.
For a jam window pie.
Yes, well, that was just with the leftovers. It wasn't a very big jam window pie, you know, it was just...
Mm. No, it wouldn't be very big on this. You couldn't do a fruit crumble there or an alternative sweet or have a milk pudding in the oven as we've got the oven on. Or a bread and butter pudding.
Yes, it could be done.
Right, well, we're on to tea now.
Tea,
those
it's bread and jam for...
Children's love.
Yes, these doorsteps for 5 days a week. Sheila tells me that the children love this, but we could possibly introduce a little variety there by using perhaps some dripping from the joint and giving them nice dripping toast or an egg sandwich occasionally or... a change from this bread and jam.
I must point out that is their choice.
Yes.
You know, and they just sit in front of the television and they do it themselves, and that's their choice when they come home from school.
Mm-hmm. It seems to me that overall, what Georgie's suggesting is that you do more baking. Now, does that mean that Sheila's going to spend hours in the kitchen?
No, baking doesn't mean spending hours in the kitchen. The things cook themselves. The actual preparation of the simple things like a bread pudding or parkin or gingerbread or a simple slap cake, it's only 10 or 15 minutes putting the things together. It's the time is saved from the shopping.
Could I just make one more point on your idea of making up menus? I agree with you along... to a certain extent, but until you actually get inside a supermarket, you don't know exactly what the bargain offers are going to be. You don't know what's going to be down, have those few coppers off in price. By all means, go out shopping with a vague idea of a week's menu, but until you actually get inside a supermarket, you can't be certain just what is going to be the cheaper things.
But I think you can be led astray by this what's going to be off. You see, if you buy ready-made apple pies because they've got 8p off, may not be cheaper than making a fresh apple pie, basically.
I was looking at sort of the meats. Now, this week, the mincemeat was on special offer at 32p
yes.
a pound. Now, I didn't know that until I got into the supermarket. So I couldn't say specifically I was going out to buy mincemeat when maybe sausages were going to be on special offer.
Yes, but
yes,
what
flexible.
Then perhaps Georgie's suggesting is that you have various ideas.
Have a basic
oh, yes,
idea.
Yes, you have a vague outline, but you can't sort of write out the menus before going to the shop because they just might not tally. Mm.
No, it needn't be specifically a menu, but you could say, we'll have a casserole tonight, and the casserole could be whatever is cheapest,
yes.
Whether
yes,
it happens
yes,
to be middle neck of mutton or shin of beef or on your roast. You don't say, we'll have roast shoulder of lamb. You could say, we'll have a roast of whatever is cheapest.
And
it might be brisket or it might be flank.
Mm-hmm.
Get the main idea that we'll have it roast tonight and we'll have it cold tomorrow.
Ladies, it was all very interesting. I want a final comment from Shelia here. Have you found this useful?
Yes, very useful.
Are you going to take up any of the suggestions? Maybe your children will enjoy them.
Yes. I would like to see their faces on eating bread and dripping, though.
Well, thank you both very much indeed.